Some plants growing in water scarcity and high temperature conditions close their stomata during daytime and open their stomata during night time. In these plants, carbon fixation takes place at night in form of malic acid, and this malic acid is stored in the vacuole of the cell. During day, the carbohydrate is synthesized from this stored carbon dioxide in form of the malic acid. Since the cycle was first observed in the plants of family Crassulaceae, the cycle was called as Crassulacean acid metabolism or the CAM cycle, and the plant which possesses this cycle are known as CAM plants. This method of carbon assimilation is found in several plant species of 20 angiospermic families like Crassulaceae, Cactaceae, Agavaceae, Orchidaceae, Portulacaceae. It is also reported from the gymnosperms, example Welwitschia mirabilis, and also from the epiphytic species of Phyllicophyta. The leaf tissue of this plant show diurnal fluctuation of the malic acid concentration. So, because of which there is an increase in the pH of the cell sap during the daytime. While during the night time, the organic acid content increases and the pH of the leaf cell sap decreases. This diurnal fluctuation depends on the movement of stomata, that is, it depends on the opening and closing of stomata. So in this CAM cycle, carbon fixation occurs at night as stomata in these plants open at night only. So the atmospheric carbon dioxide diffuses to the mesophyll cell via stomata, where it gets dissolved in water to form the carbonic acid. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme carbonic anhydrase. The carbonic anhydrase then gets ionized to form bicarbonate and the cation. The bicarbonate is accepted by the primary carbon dioxide acceptor molecule, that is PEP or phosphoenol pyruvic acid, to form the oxaloacetic acid. As we know, oxaloacetic acid is a 4-carbon compound. This reaction is catalyzed by enzyme PEP carboxylase. The exogenous carbon dioxide is trapped by PEP with the help of enzyme PEP carboxylase. So the first stable compound formed is a 4-carbon compound, that is oxaloacetic acid. The oxaloacetic acid is reduced in presence of NADPH2 to form the malic acid. So this reaction is catalyzed by NADP malate dehydrogenase. So the oxaloacetic acid is then forms the malic acid, and the enzyme is NADP malate dehydrogenase. Now the malic acid is transported to the vacuole of the cell where it is stored. Due to storage of the malic acid in the cell vacuoles, the pH of the cells gets reduced. So the exogenous carbon dioxide is taken in and is stored in form of malic acid in the large vacuoles of the cell. And so this type of carbon fixation that occurs during night is called as dark carbon fixation or assimilation. During daytime, when stomata are closed, the malic acid stored in vacuoles moves into the cytoplasm. And in the cytoplasm, the malic acid undergoes decarboxylation and forms the pyruvic acid, and it releases the carbon dioxide and also forms the NADPH2. So this reaction is catalyzed by NADP malic enzyme. So the malic acid undergoes decarboxylation, forming the carbon dioxide, and also forms the pyruvic acid. The carbon dioxide released from the malic acid serves as a substrate for RUBP, that is, the carbon dioxide is now accepted by the ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, and it enters into the C3 cycle, forming the phosphoglyceric acid, and then through this C3 cycle, the hexose are formed. Now the pyruvic acid, which is formed, is then undergoes the phosphorylation, forming the phosphoenol pyruvic acid. So the significance of this CAM cycle is that we know that the CAM plants are inhabitant of arid environment, that is, mostly they are the xerophytic plants. Hence they have adaptive characters, means they have adaptive morphological, anatomical, metabolical as well as biochemical characters which have the ecological significance. Night opening of stomata in CAM plant lose less water in comparison to day opening, as the temperature by day is more than the night. Hence the CAM pathway results in carbon gain with minimum water loss, primarily through an efficient nocturnal carbon dioxide capturing pathway when evaporation is low. The carbon dioxide produced in respiration is not released by CAM plants in the environment, but it is stored in form of mallet for the day activities. So the CAM plant can persist in less carbon dioxide and water stress environment. During adverse condition, the respiratory carbon dioxide is the sole source of carbon in CAM plants. The CAM plant is, the CAM cycle is largely a survival adaptation and not a high carbon fixation mechanism like the C4 plants. Now coming to the differences between C3, C4 and CAM plants. So first, coming to the leaf anatomy, the C3 plant doesn't show the Krohn's anatomy, whereas the C4 plants show the Krohn's anatomy, where the bundle sheet cells, they surround the vascular bundles, are called as they are arranged in form of a flower wreath. This type of anatomy is called as a Krohn's anatomy, and so this special type of anatomy is present only in C4 plants. So Krohn's anatomy is absent in C3 as well as the CAM plants, and also the C4 plants show the dimorphic type of chloroplast, that there are two types of chloroplast. The chloroplast present in mesophyll have the well-developed grana, whereas the chloroplast that are present in the bundle sheet are grana-less. Now, the primary carbon dioxide acceptor in C3 plant is RUBP, ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, whereas the primary carbon dioxide acceptor in C4 and CAM plant is phosphoenol pyruvic acid. The enzyme catalyzing primary carboxylation is the RUBPase or the Rubisco, whereas in C4 and CAM plant it is the phosphoenol pyruvic carboxylase. Then the first stable compound found in C3 plant is a phosphoglyceric acid, whereas in C4 and CAM plant the first stable compound formed is the oxaloacetic acid. The ATP required for the C3 cycle are 18 ATPs, whereas in C4 and CAM plants they require the 30 ATPs. So 12 additional ATPs are needed for the conversion of the pyruvic acid to phosphoenol pyruvic acid. The optimum temperature required for the C3 plants is 15 to 25 degree centigrade, whereas the C4 and CAM plants, they can fix the carbon at a higher temperature also. The carbon dioxide compensation point, that is the point at which the carbon dioxide released during respiration is equal to the carbon dioxide utilized during the photosynthesis, is called as carbon dioxide compensation point. So the carbon dioxide compensation point in C3 plant is very high, that is it is 50 to 150 parts per million, whereas in C4 plant it is low, that is from 0 to 10 parts per million, and in CAM plants during night it is 5 parts per million and during the daytime it is 50 parts per million. In C3 plant only C3 cycle takes place, whereas in C4 plants both C3 cycle and C4 cycle takes place. So in C4 plants the C4 cycle takes place in the mesophyll cells, whereas the C3 cycle takes place in the bundle sheet cells. So here in C4 plants there is a spatial difference between the C3 and C4 cycle, whereas in CAM plants also both the C3 and C4 cycle takes place, but here the C4 cycle takes place during the night, whereas the C3 cycle takes place during the daytime. So there is a time interval between the C3 and C4 cycle in the CAM plants. The Calvin enzyme are present in the mesophyll chloroplast of C3 plants, whereas in C4 plants the Calvin cycle enzymes are absent in the mesophyll chloroplast. So as we know that RuBP enzyme is present only in the bundle sheet cells of the C4 plants. So in CAM plants also the Calvin enzymes are present in the mesophyll cells. And in C3 plants each chloroplast has both the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, whereas in C4 plants in the bundle sheets chloroplast the photosystem 2 is absent. So this the bundle sheet cells are dependent on the mesophyll cells for the supply of NADPH2, whereas in CAM plants the chloroplast has both the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. In C3 plant the photorespiration is present. So as we know the primary acceptor of carbon dioxide in C3 plant is the RuBPase, that is the Rubisco enzyme. This Rubisco enzyme also has an oxygenase activity, that is at a high concentration of oxygen the Rubisco accept the oxygen instead of the carbon dioxide, and by accepting the oxygen and undergoing oxygenase activity it enters into the photorespiration. Whereas in C4 plants as we know the RuBP carboxylase enzyme is present deep inside the bundle sheet cell, so it is far away from the atmosphere oxygen, so the photorespiration is absent in C4 plant. The photorespiration is present in the CAM plants. Because of the photorespiration in C3 plants the photosynthesis efficiency is low in C3 plants, whereas it is high in the C4 plants. And in CAM plant also the photosynthetic efficiency is low.